Well, good morning, everyone. It's Friday, and we have a great weekend in store for us. I sure hope you're coming to church this weekend, especially if you're at Saddleback Church Laguna Woods. If you're at another church, don't miss that either. It'll be good, and you're going to be worshiping your Lord. But at Saddleback, this is Pastor Rick Warren's final sermon as senior pastor. And so it's historic. I hope you come on out. 9 and 11, Clubhouse 5, serving breakfast as always too. So we would love to see you there. Hey, we are in the midst this week of counting down the 10 shortest books in the Bible. I just thought that would be interesting. And so we're giving it a go. Have you guessed what the shortest one is yet? Or maybe you know. Maybe you know. Well, we'll find that out next week. But today we come to number 6, the 6th shortest. We're going by number of words. So the 6th shortest by words is Titus. Titus. This is the first New Testament book that we've had on our list. So that's kind of unique. It has only 898 words. It's the first one under 1,000 words that we've come to. It's found, you know, in your New Testament, right before the book of Hebrews, right after 1st and 2nd Timothy, if you're looking for it. You could read it in less than 10 minutes. So I hope you'll do that. There's a lot in there. We're going to touch on a couple of high points, but nothing like reading the whole book. Titus was a friend of Paul's, and they had been traveling together, and actually along with Timothy. And the year was about 63-64 AD, after, and they were starting to spread the gospel around to various cities. And Timothy had been left behind in Ephesus. And Paul loved Timothy. He really did. But you know what? He seems to have loved this guy named Titus also. And so they traveled together some, and then Paul leaves him in a city called Crete, C-R-E-T-E. So he writes him on how Titus could help that church, help them to avoid false teaching, help them to find elders that would be solid and the type of people that Paul knew would be important for the church to have. So you get, just like in Timothy, you get qualifications for an elder. And I encourage you to read those, because whether you're called to be an elder or not, if that's what the leaders of the church, how Paul thought they should live, then we should try to live that way also. But he goes on and he talks about how to avoid false teaching too. But in fact, let me just, we have time, I think. I'm going to read in Titus chapter 1, the qualifications for an elder at verse 6. And then this is not the verse of the day. I'm going to give you that in just a moment. An elder, verse 6, 1:6, must be blameless, the husband of but one wife, a man whose children believe and are not open to the charge of being wild and disobedient. It mattered how you were raising your children. Since an overseer is entrusted with God's work, he must be blameless, not overbearing, not quick-tempered, not given to drunkenness, not violent, not pursuing dishonest gain, but rather hospitable, one who loves what is good and who is self-controlled, upright, holy, and disciplined. New leadership, especially a new church, was so important to Paul. And important to that church, that they would have people, elders, that people could look up to. And so that's a great description, and that's a challenge to live way to live our life. But as he went on, Paul addresses various groups and encourages Titus to help these things to happen. The verse for the day is going to be chapter 2, verse 2. And I think you'll see why I chose this one. It says, let me just read it. Teach the older men to be temperate, worthy of respect, self-controlled, and sound in faith, in love, and endurance. I chose it because many of us watching fall into that category. And so that's how we men were to live, to be temperate, worthy of respect, self-controlled, sound in faith, and in an endurance. And you know what that means, men, in an endurance? Keep the faith. Finish strong. Finish strong. We don't know what the future holds for us. Well, actually, we do. Because after we pass from this life, if we are followers of Jesus Christ, we will be with him in heaven forever. And so, anything short of just staying in the faith and finishing strong, no matter what happens, is what Paul is encouraging and what I want. It does go on in chapter 2, verse 3, because ladies, I don't want you to think, oh, men ought to, no. Chapter 2, verse 3, likewise, Paul writes, teach the older women to be reverent in the way they live, not to be slanderers or addicted to much wine, but teach what is good. And then they can train the younger women to love their husbands and children, to be self-controlled and pure. So ladies, those are strong words for you also, are they not? Reverent in the way you live. Have God front and center in your life, he's saying. Not to be slanderers or addicted to much wine. Don't be gossips, in essence. But teach what is good, and so they can train younger women. I hope there's younger women in your life. Oftentimes that's daughters, but it might be any other younger people that are in contact with you. Be a mentor. Be an example to the younger women that God has put in your life. Might be grandchildren, by the actually. And that's the most. Boy, you can really impact young lives. Or maybe younger nieces and nephews, something like that. But that was so important that in this sixth shortest book in the Bible, Paul includes it as instructions to his friend Titus. So how can we do any less but to have that a part of the way we live our life? Now he goes on, and like I say, it's only basically 2 pages long in my Bible. He talks about ways to live our life. It's such a practical little book. So I hope you'll take the time to read it. I just love the Bible, don't you? It's so, people say, well, it's an old book, not practical to my life. How could it be any more practical than what we just read? Hey, well, next week, we're going to look into the 5 shortest books, and they pack a wallop also. Each one of them has important messages from God, and you and I are going to discover some of those together. So God bless. I hope to see you on Sunday, but walk closely with your Lord. He is so good to all of us. See you next week.